There are three main parts of your county homepage or Drupal 6 homepage that you can edit. The first is the announcement banner here at the top. The second is just underneath the announcement banner, and it's basically just a little news area that you can control. And the third are the sidebar items here underneath the events section. We're going to walk through how to edit each of the three sections. To create a new banner for your homepage, you go to Content Management, Create Content, and click Banner Slideshow. Once you're on the edit page, you'll want to enter your title. This is your way to identify the banner, and it will not be used on the homepage, so it won't show. You can then add a caption or call to action in the body section. This appears in the box over the image, the black or gray box. Just keep it short. Don't put links in the area. We don't want that area to be super large in text. Next, you'll upload your banner image. So you'll browse to the photo that you've saved on your desktop or on your computer and click open when you've selected it. Make sure that you have the size correct before you upload it. The banner images are 350 pixels by 170 pixels, so you'll want to make sure that it's the correct size. Otherwise, when you upload it, it will shrink and crop your image, which sometimes takes away part of the necessary parts of the image. Then you'll want to add the URL in the banner link URL field. This is where the banner links to when you click on it. Once you're done, hit save. If you want to edit the banner slideshow, there are two different ways that you can go about finding the banners that are available on your website. The first is to add /banner/ to your main URL for your website. This page was created so that you can view all of the images and access their edit buttons easily. The second option is to go to the affiliated content and affiliate site list in the main administration menu. Click on your site name, and that lists all of the content that is on your particular site. You can even filter it by the type of content, so we can filter content on this particular county. We'll go back to the banner page that we have here. So if I want to select this top image to edit it, I can select the edit link underneath of it and make any of my edits on this screen. Once I'm done making edits, I'll hit save. If I want to unpublish a banner, so unpublishing is when I want to keep the banner, I just don't want it to display on the homepage right now, but I might want to add it again later, I can unpublish it. So you go to the same avenues for finding the specific banner that you're looking for and click edit. And on the right hand side here, we have a publishing options. If I click that plus sign, I can uncheck the published box and it automatically unpublishes my banner image. If I want to delete a banner because I know that I'm not going to ever use it again, navigate to the banner page or the affiliate site list and find the banner that you're looking for, clicking edit. And on the right side of the page here, you can see this delete button. Just go ahead and click delete. You'll be asked to confirm that you wish to permanently delete the banner. Go ahead and click delete again. You can also schedule a publish time for your banner. If you want to upload a banner before you leave work for the day, but you actually don't want it to publish until Saturday, you could set it up in advance and not have to worry about getting on the weekend. So again, find the banner that you want to schedule, click edit. And then off to the right, we have the scheduling options. Click the plus sign button, and you can see that you can schedule a publish on or an unpublish on date. So you can actually schedule it to be published on a certain date and time and schedule it to be unpublished on a certain date and time. You don't have to schedule both. You could just schedule one. And you can see when I hover over one of the boxes here, I get this green little box drop down, and it tells me what format I have to type it in. So you just leave this blank if you don't want to schedule it to be published on or schedule it to be unpublished on specific dates. But if you want to schedule it, you can just use this format here and type it in or copy and paste. That's usually what I do. I copy and paste this information, put it up here, and then I change it to what I need it to be. That is basically how you add, edit, or delete any banners on your homepage. Now we're going to talk about editing this welcome message here that appears to the right of all of your banner images. You can edit this by clicking on the edit button in the black box on the right-hand side of your screen. And you'll see this is the message that showed up. So we can edit this to whatever we want it to be. Try to keep the welcome message as concise as possible. You'll notice when you look at that banner image, there isn't a bunch of room, so we don't want it to be very long. Underneath that, we have the announcements area. To edit this little area here above the county news part, go ahead and click edit on the homepage again in the black box. And this homepage area one is the portion that shows up right beneath the banner and above the county news feed that pulls in. So go ahead and edit that as you need, change it. This is great to change throughout the season if you have a job opening that you want to post. For instance, this is particular to master gardeners, making sure they log their volunteer hours. Lots of different stuff that you can put in here. Go ahead and save when you're done making changes. This area, you want to make sure that you only put critical long-term information. You use news for temporary information and the sidebar areas for permanent links. So we don't want to have to be changing our homepage every day because we're putting in information that's only viable for a day or two. You'll end up forgetting or get busy and not have time to do it, and then your homepage will be outdated. So just make sure that you put in information that can stay on there for a while that's a little more long-term. Next, we'll talk about homepage area two. Now, this area is located below the county news feed that pulls in. You can use this for additional content on your homepage that does not need to be at the top of the page. So you'll access this the same way you did before on the homepage. Click the edit button and just fill in any information in this homepage area two box. To edit the sidebars, will be on the same screen here, and as I scroll down, you can see the sidebar area 3 and sidebar area 4. Go ahead and enter any information that you want into those boxes. You can add a title to the top of your box by highlighting the title and making sure that it's a heading 6. This makes it a title, and we'll go back here so that you can see what it looks like. You'll see that this is actually the title that we put in. And it just sets the box apart a little bit and lets you know what's in that information. That is all you need to do to edit your homepage.